And over while, our letters take the place. I've been asked to make some remarks, but I don't have a script. And I'm only 3 months short of 98, so I hope you give me some thought. Great day to be here in our beautiful state capital. I don't know why I was elected. I don't have a script, but I'll try to convey some of the experience that I have. I was first sergeant of Company K, 325 Fighter Infantry, and we took off the gliders on D+1. And we were in what was called a horse glider. This was a British glider. And I think that was a big mistake. But anyway, we got up in the morning in the camp. We traveled to the airport and we loaded. We started our flight over the camp, which was very quiet. Well, there wasn't too much talking or anything else going on, I guess, from the little silent room. Anyway, we landed, and it was a flooded area, which the Germans, I guess, had a pretty good idea of where they were going to land. So they put up obstacles to make the damage as they could, I guess. Anyway, I guess it was a luck that we landed in a flooded area. Because an awful lot of the gliders took out hedgerows and trees, and they didn't fare well for that pressure. A lot of casualties due to the landing. Anyway, we and our particular glider back was in, we all got okay. The water was, when I got out, the water was right up to my chin. We had to wait to get up on the ground. And we were under small arms from mortar fire. We managed to get back without any casualties. Anyway, the first day was mostly spent organizing and getting back together because we were scattered all over. Then the second day was quite quiet. But then on the third day, General Ridgway ordered us to secure the causeway, which was called the Fair Causeway, which the troopers had tried to dig the day before and were not able to do. That was, so we got a good baptism for combat right off the bat. But we stormed right through and we managed to get to the other that we moved. In fact, we got there to last something. A lot of the Germans were still in their dugouts, boxhole, so we had to throw a hand grenade to get us to come out. It was a terrific loss. We paid the terrible price. And after the second day, I was asked to send one or two guys to help police up the bodies, and there was a little orchard at the far end of the causeway, and they were stacked the bodies there, it was kind of gruesome. They stacked the Americans in one pile and the Germans in the other. And the fellow that I sent, when he returned after having all those casualties, he was the whitest of sheep.